Well, good Sunday evening to you. Welcome to our Facebook Live service. We are back inside the church building tonight doing a Facebook Live service only. But again, for all those that tuned in this morning, those who came on property with our drive-in style service, boy, what a great time in the Lord we had today. The top of my head looks like that I had just left the Holy of Holies because, man, the sun was beating down. Brother Wayne said next week we may set up a little tent area right up there at the top of the hill where our services are at. But, boy, we were so glad for you to tune in. I was looking on my computer just before I stepped in for the service. It looks like right now 1,400 people roughly have watched this morning's service. Just blows my mind the amount of folks that are tuning in to the service in these days. What a great opportunity God's given us in this hour to be a voice and a bright and shining light for Jesus Christ. And so again, thank you for tuning in this evening. Thank you for coming and being prepared to sing when we sing, to pray when we pray, to have your Bibles open, following along, making decisions, growing closer to Jesus Christ in this hour. So again, we're glad that you tune in with us. Looking forward to getting right into the song service. Much to sing about as we worship King Jesus. What do you have for us tonight, Brother Andrew?
We're going to begin this evening singing a few songs about worship, and we're going to start with Majesty.
Majesty, worship His Majesty. Unto Jesus be all glory, honor, and praise. Majesty, kingdom, authority, flow from His throne unto His own, His anthem raise. So exalt, lift up on high the name of Jesus. Magnify, come glorify Christ Jesus the King.
Good evening. We are so glad to have you join us on Facebook Live. Thank you so much for that. Looking forward to worshiping the Lord together with you tonight and seeing what the Lord is going to do in this service. Just want to give you a couple of prayer requests. Miss Jean Goff, please continue to remember her with her physical condition going on. Harry Joyner also has some things physical we need to pray for. Miss Becky Garner, please continue to remember her. And Alan and Misty Walston, also the difficult time they're going through physically and emotionally as well, as well as so many of us. Life has changed drastically. Some may never be the same, but praise the Lord, we've got Him to look forward to no matter what. So let's go ahead and pray together, if you would. Heavenly Father, Lord, we love You, we praise You, we thank You so much for the service this morning, God. We thank You for Palm Sunday, God, what we had to celebrate, and really looking forward to next week, Lord. And God, we just thank You, Lord, for the sweet spirit You can give us anywhere we are, no matter what room we're in, God. And thank You for allowing us to worship You. And we love You, we praise You, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Again, thank you so much for those who were able to make it this morning. Like the pastor said, let's get out and share the message, the good news of Jesus Christ, and those at Facebook Live, those there on church site, and even people you didn't even know that were listening and watching. Andrew and I were sitting over by the gymnasium, and all of a sudden something caught my eye beside the preacher. I looked, and There were two guys sitting in chairs that looked like fishing over in the corner, back over by Continued Creek. And then I looked and they were moving. Well, they were in a boat and they were backed up in the little canal and they were listening to the pastor preach. And they must have got convicted. About 20 minutes later, they fired that thing up and got out of there. I said, Andrew, they must have been under conviction. But look, so many people hearing the sound of the gospel, and that's a wonderful, wonderful thing. Let's pray for one another. And as we continue on in the service, we're going to pull a choir special out of the vault. As you can listen now.
The only thing I want in life.
I'm so thankful that we can put our trust, our confidence in the Lord, and that we can advance the gospel through the cause of Jesus Christ. We're going to give you a chance to do some singing with us at home as we've heard this good music from the vault of the Mount Calvary Choir. What do you have for us, Brother Andrew?
You know, in the world we live in, we have a lot of people that consider themselves Christian. You know, they might have gotten saved, but they haven't surrendered anything to God. And living the Christian life is just more than the opportunity to go to heaven, but it's serving our Lord Jesus Christ with our lives. And, you know, something that these few months has proven is the fact about how fragile our worldly stuff are. You know, 20 million Americans have lost their jobs. You know, what does it benefit having all these nice things? We're not able to do anything with them. A lot of people are going to have to sell what they have. And, you know, but, you know, one thing that will always last is what we do for Christ, what we do for Him. And my prayer tonight is that we will look at all of our lives, and if we've never, you know, we're Christians, we're saved, but have we ever prayed and said, Lord, here's my whole life. Here's my kids, here's my job. You know, we have a lot of Christians that go to church, but they don't take any kind of responsibilities whatsoever. They're content with just sitting in a pew Sunday morning, and they've fulfilled their Christian duty for the week. But have you asked the Lord, you know, what can I do for my church? Is there a place that I can serve? And, you know, I hope when all this is over and we are able to join back together that we will just have so many people willing to serve around our ministry. And, you know, just willing to say, Lord, here's my life. Take every part. Whatever you want me to do, I'm willing to do that. So that's my prayer this evening. We're going to sing this song together. All I ever want to be is what you want of me.
All I ever want to be is what you want of me, Lord. I give my life to you and all my hopes and dreams and plans I place within your hands, Lord. I give my life to you. I am, Lord, use me. Take my life and mold me. All I ever want to be is what you want of me, Lord. I give my life to you, and all my hopes and dreams and plans I place within your hands, Lord. I give my life to you. Every day you give me grace, I find my strength in you, Lord. I give my life to you, and though it seems that I will fail, through you I will prevail, Lord. I give my life to you. Here I am. Lord, I offer my life to you.
Amen. And that is the theme throughout this service this evening in music is, Lord, here am I, like a blank check. You fill in the place. You fill in the amount. Lord, here's my life. Use me. We've come to that time in our service when we give folks an opportunity to continue to be able to give. As we've talked about over the last several weeks, we're not living in normal times. Normal times, our ushers would come down the aisle of our church. We would pray over the offering. We would pass an offering plate. But now, because we're at home in social distancing, unable to meet on the pews as we have been accustomed to our life, our giving, the way that we give, has changed some. And so let me remind you of some ways that you can give here during our offering time. First of all, for those right now watching me on Facebook Live, we have the ability through our church website for you to do your giving. And so if you'd like to, while Brother Andrew's playing the offertory here in a few minutes, go to MountCalvaryFWBChurch.com. At the very bottom of the homepage, you will see the word donate. If you click on that word, and you'll see a PayPal feature pop up. You can put in the dollar amount, and you can give your weekly tithes and offerings through PayPal. A number of people are beginning to use that method. The second method is just a good old-fashioned mail service by mailing in your weekly tithes and offerings to Mount Calvary Free Will Baptist Church. That's P.O. Box 250, Hookerton, North Carolina, 28538. And then thirdly, during the week, between the hours of 10 and 2, Monday through Friday, Brother Kevin, Miss Karen are here in the office specifically looking for folks who come in to drop off their weekly tithes and offerings. If you can't come at that time, if you'll give us a call, we can accommodate a time that works for you. And so at this time, we're going to put a slide up on the screen for those who are doing online at-home giving. You can use that slide as your resource. Brother Andrew's going to begin to play, and we'll give you a chance to give to the Lord.
Thank you so much, Brother Andrew. I know there's a lot of things over the years that I've really taken for granted. I know one of those things, maybe choir practice even. You know, all the times, but Brother Andrew said, choir practice, 4:30. You know, I always enjoy choir practice, but it's not something that I said that, you know, we weren't going to be able to have one day, or, you know, or I thought about that was me worshiping the Lord at choir practice. As Allen Iverson said, you know, practice, we're talking about practice. But, man, I really miss that. I miss singing with my brothers and sisters in the choir, practicing with them in choir. I miss the bus route, being able to pick up those boys and girls, men and women, for Jesus Christ, and being in the Sunday school classes and the children's church classes. I've taken a lot of things for granted. So like Brother Andrew said, when we get back, may we hit the Lord's work 110%, just wide open, and serve Him like we never have before, because we don't know how much longer we have on this earth. At this time, our special music is going to be pulled from the vault again.
So you can follow along. We're in the book of Philippians, chapter number 4. I was talking to some of the media team, and one of our camera switchers is not able to quite move as it normally would right now with that technical difficulty. And so as a preacher, I told the guys, listen, I will try to stay up on the platform area this morning. I got some practice in because the microphoning outside at the drive-in service, I was right behind the mic, so at least tonight they've uncaged the preacher and I'm able to move around a little bit over here, move around a little bit over there, but I'm going to try to stay on the stage area tonight as I preach and as you watch from home this service with me. So Philippians chapter 4, notice here in verse number 1, the Apostle Paul writes, therefore, my brethren, dearly beloved, and longed for, my joy and crown. So now notice with me these next 5 words. If you make it a practice to write in your Bibles, I want you to underscore them, but let's say them out loud together from home as we are watching the service together. Stand fast in the Lord. My dearly beloved, notice in verse number 4, he skips on and says, rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto, what is that little 3-letter word? Let's say it together. All men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth, what's that word? All understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Let's skip down to verse number 11. Paul says, not that I speak in respect of want, for I have learned in whatsoever state I am, therewith to be content. I know both how to be abased, and I know how to abound. Everywhere and in, there's that word again, let's say it, all things. I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need. Verse 13, I can do, what's that word? All things through Christ which strengtheneth me. Notice verse 18. But I have, there's that word, let's say it, all and abound. I am full, having received of Epaphroditus the things which were sent from you, an odor of a sweet smell, a sacrifice acceptable, well-pleasing to God, but my God shall supply, here's that word again, let's say it, all your need, according to its riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Now unto God and our Father be glory forever and ever. Amen. Let's pray together. Father, I love you. And I'm glad tonight that I serve the God of all. A-L-L. Lord, in the midst of this difficult time, Lord, my confidence, my hope, my help, my anchor for the soul, it's in you. So, Father, as we look to this passage tonight, I pray that you would speak to us. Lord, that you would speak through me. Lord, tonight it's not important that folks see me or hear me, but God, it is direly important in this critical hour folks hear you and folks see you. So, Father, again, speak to me and through me. I pray in this hour we pray in Jesus' name, amen and amen. As we've been saying over the last several weeks, we are certainly living in a different time in our world. We're living in a time unlike anything that any of us who are alive have ever seen before. I'm thinking about how that I've read some about this Spanish flu of the 1918s, 1919, even going into 1920. And the reality is most of us were never alive then. And so what we're going through in these days, it is different. It is unprecedented. And as we go through this hour and we're facing these difficulties and we're facing these storms and there's so much uncertainty, there's so much fear, there's so much anguish, there's so much anxiety in our society, so many people are wondering in these days, what do I hitch my hope to, preacher? Where can I put my confidence in? And here we find, in Philippians chapter 4, the Apostle Paul finds himself in that same boat. Paul here in this letter, as he writes to the church at Philippi, is under house arrest. He's facing a difficult time in his life. For Paul, he's not sure what the future is going to hold for him. For in just a few days, it would be possible that Paul would stand before Caesar. He may would find out that his life here on this side of heaven would be over, that his earthly ministry would end, and there was a lot of uncertainty up in the air. And in the midst of that, as he's closing out this letter, which, by the way, the theme of Philippians is a theme of joy. Think about that. A man under house arrest, a man that it was altogether possible that it would not be long before he would be executed, because, again, he was not sure when that time would come, and it could be any time. And yet, in the midst of that, Paul wrote a book dealing with the subject of joy. Aren't you glad that our joy doesn't have to be based in circumstances, but our joy can be tied up in Jesus? And tonight we can be going through this time of the coronavirus, and we can still have joy in our soul. But Paul said, in this hour, as he faced the uncertainty of the future, in verse 1 of chapter number 4, Paul exhorts us and those who were at Philippi to stand fast in the Lord. And you know, as we move ahead into this week, the upcoming weeks, according to the president, according to the medical professionals, as best they can tell, some of the worst of the coronavirus is what lies ahead. The death toll is going to rise. The cases that are popping up around the country are going to continue to spike. And in days like this, and with the volatility of the stock market, 2 days it's up and 3 days it's down, and with the economy being uncertain and more people being laid off and all the things that are taking place in America right now. Brother Andrew talked about during the music portion of the service how that, you know, Americans have been blessed and we have all these toys and trinkets, and now these things are being taken away from us, or we have them and we can't even use them. Where do we put our confidence in this difficult hour? Where do we go from here? May I suggest to you that our hope is not in the CARES Act. And by the way, I'm thankful for what the government has tried to do for Americans and small businesses, and I'm not against it, but make no mistake, our hope's not in the CARES Act. Our hope isn't in President Trump and the medical team that serves as the coronavirus task force. And again, I support our president. I'm glad for his advisors, but dear child of God, tonight, what we're facing, the answer is not found in politics. The answer is not found in a stimulus package. Our hope, our help, our anchor is in the Lord. The Apostle Paul says, in this hour, stand fast in the Lord. That word stand fast is a military term. It actually means, and we'll throw the definition up on your screen at home, it says to refuse to abandon one's opinion or belief, to hold firm, to stand pat. As believers in this hour, what Paul is encouraging us to do as we're about ready to move into a very difficult and could be dark time in America and in Eastern North Carolina and in our communities and all around the global world, in this hour, to take our feet and be stand fast in the Lord. You know, I read a statement, and I believe that Thomas Paine hit it right on the head when he said these words. These are the times that try men's souls. This hour right now in Eastern North Carolina, this hour in America, this hour in the world is the time that really puts our Christianity to the test. It's easy to live for God when the economy's booming. It's easy to live for God when everyone's well and everything is normal. But you let the world be turned upside down like it is in this hour. And all of a sudden, this is the time where the cream of Christianity can rise to the top, and folks can look at our lives in this hour and say, what you have isn't phony. What you have isn't a fairy tale. What you have isn't science fiction. But what you have is real in Jesus Christ. I want something that gives me what you have in the Lord. These are the times that try men's souls. This is a time where the world can see, like the old Chinese proverb, that we're more than just a bunch of talkie-talkie, but that we are men and women of walkie-walkie. We live out our faith. So tonight, for the next few minutes, I want us to look here in Philippians chapter 4. As we as North Carolinians are about to face the eye of the storm, as it's barreling down on our state, as it's barreling on the United States of America, as some of the most difficult parts of the coronavirus lie ahead, as it's bearing down. I want to give you three reasons tonight, church, why we need to stand fast in the Lord. Three reasons to stand fast in the Lord. First of all, we see in verses 6 and 7, we need to stand fast in the Lord because in the Lord we're able to have all peace. All peace. Look with me, if you will, in verse 6 and 7. Paul writes, "Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God." Look at verse 7. "And the," what's those three words? Say them at home with me. "Peace of God." Please get your pen out and underline those three beautiful words. The peace of God which passeth, what's those next two words? All understanding. Circle that word all, underline that phrase all understanding. Dear child of God, I'm glad tonight as believers, when we give the coronavirus, COVID-19 to the Lord each day, when we give our worries to the Lord each day, listen, when we give our financial concerns to the Lord each day, there's a peace that God can give us that passeth all understanding, that can see us through this difficult time we're about ready to go into. Dear child of God, He has promised us as believers, if we'll trust Him, if we'll look to Him, He will provide all peace. My entire life, I've heard the expression that there's peace in the eye of the storm. It's a proven fact that when hurricanes move ashore, that when the eye is directly over the place where it makes landfall, inside the eye, there is a complete peace and a complete calm. I'm glad for the child of God that when the eye of the coronavirus is barreling down on our communities, listen, when we don't know if we're going to be able to stand up to the winds, that our God will stand there beside of us, not like a fair weather friend, but He will stay beside us and He will give us peace and He will see us through. I like what Sheila Walsh once said about peace. She said, "Peace is not the absence of trouble. It is the presence of Christ." Let me say that one more time. Peace is not the absence of trouble. It's the presence of Christ. Real Christianity in these days, God may not choose to deliver us from the trouble of the coronavirus. God may not choose, listen, to spare our country from some of the economical sufferings that we are going through. And listen, as Brother Justin mentioned this evening when he was sharing some things in the preliminaries, on the other side of this, things in our country may never quite be like it was before again, but I'm glad to report to you that through it all, that God will be faithful. Through it all, God's willing to be there with us. And if we will trust Him, His peace, His presence will see us through. Paul says, stand fast in the Lord. Why? Because He's the God of all peace. But not only do we see that He is the God of all peace, but Paul says, stand fast in the Lord because He's the God of all power. Look with me in verse number 12. Paul writes, "I know both how to be abased and I know how to abound. Everywhere and in all things I am instructed both to be full and to be hungry, both to abound and to suffer need." Look in verse 13. Let's read this verse aloud together. Many of you have it memorized. "I can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me." Paul reminds us that he had learned in his life both how to be abased, also how to abound. How to be full, but also hungry. how to abound, but also to suffer need. Here's the reality. It don't require a lot of faith. It doesn't require the ability to be a good Christian. Listen, to live for God and have joy in your life when everything's going well. When the wind's to our back, listen, when we feel like we've got the world by the tail on a downhill swing, it's easy to live for God in those moments. But I'm going to tell you when it gets difficult is when the wind is howling and is pushing against us. When our apple cart has been turned over. When we feel like that our world has been turned upside down. And I'm not so sure tonight, Brother Andrew and Brother Justin, that God may not have allowed some of what's taking place right now in our country to upset our apple cart and to get us to a place where we'll really trust God like we ought to. To get us to a place that instead of trusting in our toys and trusting in our trinkets and trusting in all of our worldly goods, that we'd get to a place that the most important thing in our life above everything else is King Jesus, and that we would trust in Him. Listen, it's going to get tough in the weeks ahead. But I want you to know something. That God is willing to give us the strength to see His children through it if we will just trust the Lord. You know, there's a little statement. I have said it several times the last several weeks that has just kind of been a mantra in my mind as I've went through. And it simply goes like this. If God brings you to it, He will bring you through it. There's no question, God has brought all of us to this moment of the coronavirus. COVID-19 didn't show up one day, and God had no idea it was going to happen. No, God brought it to our doorstep, to our time in history. Here in this passage, Paul reminds us that if we, as we walk through this time, say, Lord, I just want for you to teach me in these days. And Lord, I want you to help me to make whatever adjustments that you want me to make in my life. But Lord, I need your grace and strength. He has promised us, I can do all things through Christ, which strengtheneth me. I've often wondered how the folks who went through the Great Depression, how they did it. If you've ever met anyone, maybe your grandparents or great-grandparents, went through the Great Depression, they tell you some of the stories of the sacrifices and the struggles and the difficulties they went through in those days, and yet as they went through it, it did not break their spirit, and they were able to go through it in joy, and they were able to face it, listen, still being faithful to God. How did they go through that? With that type of spirit and attitude, I'll tell you why. Because they said, Lord, we're going to live for you, we're going to serve you, we're going to trust you, and we're asking you to give us the grace to get through this. And God gave them the grace and the power that they need. And you listen, dear child of God, as we get ready to face the eye of the storm, God will give us the grace and the power we need as we face the storm. So I'm glad that I have to report to you, stand fast, Lord, because there's all peace. Stand fast, Lord, because there is all power. But let me give you a third thing that Paul gives us here in Philippians 4. And that is we are to stand fast in the Lord because He gives us all provision. Look with me in verse 18. Paul says, but I have, what's that word again? Let's say it out loud at home. All. I abound, I am full. Having received of Epaphroditus the things which were sent from you, an odor of a sweet smell, a sacrifice acceptable, well-pleasing to God. But my God, by the way, if you're a born-again, blood-bought child of the King, He's your God too. You can say, hey, this is Justin's God. This is Andrew's God. This is Andy's God. This is Wayne's God. This is Kevin's God. This is David's God. This is Preacher Frank's God. Put your name in the blank, but my God shall supply all your need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. You write this down and don't you ever forget this, dear child of God. God takes care of His children. I read this afternoon and I thought how true it is. The statement went like this. I'm not afraid of tomorrow because I know that God is already there. I'm not afraid of tomorrow because I know that God is already there. You know, I don't know what the death toll or the new cases will be like tomorrow. I don't know what the death toll or the new cases will be like when we come back together this coming Easter Sunday morning for services. Listen, I don't know how bad it may get in this country, but I know one thing tonight. As a child of God, I serve the God whose heavenly Father owns the cattle on a thousand hills, and God will provide and take care of His children. Listen to me tonight. If you're at home watching this service, God's going to help you with your bills. Tonight, God's going to help you with your business. God's going to help you with your bread. God's going to help you with your bed. Whatever your needs are, whether it's your bills, your business, your bread, or your bed, listen, God will take care of you. Can I tell you something? Even in this difficult hour, I feel so blessed tonight. I've not missed a meal yet. I've got a roof over my head. Listen, I've got clothes to wear. I've got four children and a precious wife. I've got a church family that loves me. Listen, I get to live in the greatest country in all the world. Listen, I'm spoiled rotten. God's been good to me. You know what I know tomorrow as we go to tomorrow? I don't know what the future holds, but I do know who holds the future. I know this in my soul, no matter how bad it may get, God's going to take care of me. God's going to take care of you. God's going to look out for you. David says, I've been young and now I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken or his seed begging bread. Paul says, I don't know what my future holds. He said, listen, to me to live is Christ, to die is gain. I'm not sure what the future holds. He said, but I've made up my mind that I'm going to do something, and I want to encourage all of you as believers to do the same thing. I'm going to stand fast in the Lord. I'm reminded of the song that the children sing in the booster band. They'll take the Bible, and they'll hold it in their hands, and they'll move back and forth like this, and they'll sing, the B-I-B-L-E, yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the Word of God, the B-I-B-L-E. Dear child of God, listen, you can stand on God's Word in these days and say, I'm going to put my trust in the Lord. And as we go through this difficult time, God has promised me He'll give me all peace. God has promised me He'll give me all power. God has promised me that He will give me all provision. So tonight, dear friends, as we go into these upcoming days, let's stand fast in the Lord. Let's bow for prayer. Our heads are bowed, our eyes are closed. There, as you sit in your living room, kitchen, bedroom, hotel room, wherever you may be watching this service, some of you perhaps in the community, sitting around your radio, listening to the service on FM 100.1. Tonight, we've heard the reports. We've seen what the president has said. We've seen what the medical professionals have said. We've watched the stock market. We've watched the economy. And in this hour, my encouragement to us, my admonition to us, it's what Paul reminds us of. Listen, these weren't just some man that had everything going good, and because everything was going good in his life, he could write these words and not relate with us. Hey, he was looking down the gun barrel with an uncertainty ahead, and he says, I've made up my mind. What I'm going to do is I'm going to stand fast in the Lord. And I don't want to challenge us in these hours. Listen, stand fast in the Lord. Maybe you're tonight not being able to rest as well at night. Maybe you've been dealing with some anxiety, some fears, some worries. May I challenge you right now and say, Lord, help me to trust you. I'm going to lay this thing at your feet. I'm going to trust you with the coronavirus. I'm going to trust you with my bills. I'm going to trust you with my business decisions. I'm going to trust you with the things that's been troubling my heart. Lord, if we'll do that as a child of God, he says, in the peace of God which passeth all understanding, he can give us that peace right now. Maybe listen, as you're going through this, you say, preacher, I just don't feel like I can take another step. I just feel so burdened down. Listen, God's promised us we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Just ask God to give you the strength. one day at a time. Lord, give me the strength to take one day at a time, one step at a time, 1 hour at a time, one decision at a time. Lord, I need your power. Maybe right now you've got some needs coming up and you're just not sure how it's going to happen. You've got some bills coming due. You're not sure where it's going to come from. Listen, you put your faith and trust in God. You live for him and do what's right. God will take care of you. Father, tonight I pray that you'd help us in this hour to stand fast, oh Lord. I pray in this hour that this world around us can see up close and in a crisis moment what real Christianity is, that God is more than a crutch. God is more than just something that people cling to. But God is real. He lives in our heart. And he's alive and well and involved in the workings of men's lives today. And he is able to give us the joy, the peace, the power, the provision that we need in this hour. May you show yourself strong in our lives in these days so that those around us in our sphere of influence would see real, genuine Christianity and would say, I want what they have. Through this crisis, many, many multitudes would turn to know Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. We love you and we praise you in Jesus' name. And all God's people at home said, amen and amen. Thank you for tuning in tonight to our Sunday night service here on Facebook Live. Please don't forget, Wednesday night we'll be back with you again by Facebook Live at 7 p.m. Next Sunday morning, Easter Sunday, Lord willing, weather permitting, we will be back at 11 a.m. not only on Facebook Live, but in our drive-in style service. Boy, what a blessing it was today to be together like that. So I want to encourage you to share tonight's service with all of your Facebook friends. Let's get the gospel and the preaching of God's word viral around our area and around the world so all can hear the truths of God's word for encouragement, for edification, and for evangelizing the lost and dying world. So share the night service. Tune in Wednesday night. Come on Sunday. Bring folks with you. Staying in your cars, doing it safely, but sharing in the Lord's day together on Easter Sunday. We'll talk a little bit more about Easter on Wednesday night. Thank you for tuning in. We love you. We appreciate you. We're praying for you. Good night.